Bernard Tobin here, joined now by Ken Ferrie, the well-known independent crop consultant from Crop Tech. Ken, welcome to Canada. Always great to have you on Real Agriculture.
Glad to be here.
I want to talk about residue management. And you mentioned, you know, whether it's above ground, below ground, no-till, in tillage, you know, there's a lot of risk involved. But the bottom line is you really want to create a vertical environment.
Yeah, we're looking for a vertical environment, and that can come in so many different ways. But vertical environment is meaning that water moves actually up and down vertically through our soil, which has a big factor on infiltration, which is your water supply. How much rain do you actually get in the field when it rains? But it's also a huge factor on how high we can lift water off the water table, so our usable water supply. It's also part of how we keep oxygen in the soil and how we get the root systems to grow deep. There's a lot of ways to farm in a vertical format. It's not just one way, but if we can get to there, then it tends to take away some of the fears of a dry August and July in corn or a poor start.
But unfortunately, you mentioned, we run into horizontal problems. You know, whether it's plow, you know, soles or pans. How do we tackle those?
Probably the big thing when we talk about horizontal bulk density changes, everybody understands compaction. You go out and disc a field in wet conditions, you're going to put in a compaction layer. Bulk density changes are similar, but they can be caused even when you work a field horizontally in a dry condition, or it's been worked in the past horizontally, and the evidence of that's still there, or maybe it's a soil condition due to glaciers and everything else. So the big thing is to go out and identify if it's there, and if it is, where it is. So finding the bulk density change in the soil becomes something that we have to look below ground. We can do some spying above ground with probes and that type of thing, but the best time to look for density layers is right in the middle of the crop. So you have the root system there and you have water movement there to help pinpoint you to if there is a change, where that change is.
What's the best approach, Ken, from an equipment perspective, you know, rippers and stuff like that, to taking out some of those challenging layers?
The challenging layer depends on where it is, how deep it is. You know, so layers that are 9-10 inches deep, they're going to require to be able to reach it. In some cases, soils have a natural hardpan in them too deep, and all you can do is respect it and farm around it so you don't put your high populations there and you try to manage the drainage and that type of thing. But once you've identified where the layer is, typically we want to get below it and try to lift it out, and typically 1 to 2 inches below that layer. If it's a small enough layer, small enough issue, you might be able to do it with a cover crop. You might be able to put some type of bio channel through it and alleviate some of the pressure.
Right. Hey, final question for you, and you've heard this from a number of growers here in Ontario. A lot of no-till, a lot of guys wondering, hey, is it worth, if I have, you know, a lot of tracks in the field, you know, obviously some challenging potential compaction, is it worth going in there and doing some tillage?
The track issue depends a little bit on the crop. Soybeans? Maybe not. If you got a good drill, good no-till planter, and you can get through those tracks, get the stand established, and the soybean will compensate for those tracks pretty well. In corn, if you got 2.5-3 inch lug marks out there from the combine, and the good thing about no-till is it's usually tracks, not ruts, but if it's just tracks, yeah, then bringing in something like a vertical till pass with a Salford or a turbo till or something like that, and all you're going to do is pulverize that wheel track and break it up and allow the planter then to move through there and plant it, that's a pretty good pass to keep you on track. If it's a rut, we're talking 3 to 6, 8 inches deep, no tilling into that, and a harrow pass isn't going to fix it. You're going to have to apply tillage to that to fill those ruts in, and then you may have to come back a year from now and finish the compaction that was put in with that rut as well.